Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's me, Yenny, and for today's Mental Health Monday, I wanted to talk about how to talk to someone who has depression. This topic is obviously extremely important. Statistics show that many people who suffer with depression end up not really sharing with the people close to them. I think just as a society and culture, we're used to kind of doing the typical, hey, how are you? I'm fine, and you? And we like to take the attention off of us and put it on someone else. And just numbers show, especially for people who are struggling with depression, talking about it can be really, really difficult. So at least for me, these tips that I've learned throughout the years have helped me to better understand and be there to support people in my life who may be struggling with depression. So I hope that these tips can help you out as well. And of course, one single YouTube video is not the end-all be-all to your information and resources when it comes to this topic. So as usual, I will be linking a ton of resources in the description box down below. So please make sure to check that out if you have more questions or if you would just like to read and learn more about this topic and related topics. And yes, let's just get straight into the video. The number one thing we can do to help someone who is struggling with depression is engage with them. I think a lot of the times when topic of mental health comes up, topic of depression especially comes up, we might feel a bit like, ooh, maybe they just want to be left alone. I don't know how to talk to them. I don't want to say anything to offend them. I say this because I myself have had these thoughts in the past where someone close to me could have said they're going through something, and because I'm too scared of hurting them or saying the wrong thing, I might have just stood back and been like, maybe they'll just handle it on their own. But it's really, really important to engage. Like I said, it's so hard for those struggling with depression to speak up. So the fact that this person in your life may have spoken up about their depression, it is a sign that they may want you to engage with them. So how do we engage and like start this conversation with someone who may be struggling with depression? Here are a few things you could say to them. Do you want to talk about it? This is important because whether you're a mental health professional like myself or whether you know not a single thing about depression, number one thing is asking permission on this topic, right? Because even if this person may have opened up to you, letting them know maybe explicitly or through some sort of signs that they may be struggling with depression, it is a very sensitive topic and a very personal and intimate conversation. So it is very important to ask for permission. Do you want to talk about it? And some common responses could be, you know, because this is such a sensitive topic, even if this person may have opened up to you, they could respond with, no, I'm fine, and kind of shut you down. But it's important to realize that when a lot of people say they're fine, we're not really fine, right? A lot of the times I tell people, oh yeah, I'm fine, I'm good, and internally I'm going through a lot of things. So it's the same for anyone else. So, but even if we understand all of this in the background, we have to realize we have to respect their wishes. If they don't want to talk about it at that time, that's that, don't push. One thing you could say in those situations is, I'm here for you when you're ready to talk about it. This is a way of leaving the door open where if someone says, hey, oh yeah, I'm fine, I have depression, but I'm fine, and you're like, okay, sure, we won't talk about it. The door is kind of closed, right? But if you let them know, hey, I'm here when you're ready to talk about it, you're letting them know, all right, I respect your wishes, we don't have to talk about it now, but when you are ready, I am someone that you can feel safe talking to. And that could mean the world to that person, and it shows them that you support them. Another thing you could say to someone who has started to engage in maybe wanting to talk about their depression with you is there anything I can do to help? A lot of the times people could say, no, I'm good, don't worry about it. But this question is really important because we're going to come back to this question again. This question of, is there anything I can do to help, can be helpful in the way it shows them that, hey, I'm here to support you, not just through my words, but through my actions, which could mean so much to them, but also could lead to concrete things that a person struggling with depression might have trouble doing. For example, many people struggling with depression, it's hard for them to, you know, take care of themselves physically, whether it's cooking dinner or maybe even taking a shower or sleeping normally, or engaging in maybe everyday quote-unquote normal activities that they may have been able to engage with before they started struggling with these symptoms of depression. So the anything I can do to help today shows them, today, is there anything I can do for you? Like, oh, after we talk today, what are you going to get for dinner? Want me to order you something? It's a way of showing them that you want to help them beyond words. The next thing we can do to talk to someone who is struggling with depression is check in with them. So you've had those initial conversations with them. This is so crucial to constantly, consistently check in with this person. Just because you've had that first conversation doesn't mean it's over. Assumptions can lead to a lot of damage, and I can tell you myself, I've assumed a lot of things about people. I just think I know about X, Y, and Z, but at the end of the day, assumptions are not facts. And so we can't just assume that someone is going to be okay just because they said they're okay. Just because we had that conversation a month ago and they told me they're fine doesn't mean a month later they're still fine. So this is a person that you care about, that you want to show them you support them. It's imperative that you check in with them. And how do we check in with someone who has depression? Something we could say is, how are you managing? How is your depression? These questions are important because depression is a medical condition. A lot of the times in our world, when we talk about mental health illnesses and physical illnesses, there seems to be a difference in the way that a lot of people are treated. When someone breaks a leg, you don't just say, hey, how's your leg? Okay, you're good, cool, and just forget about it. You check in with them, right? Like, how's your leg healing? Are you okay? Are you walking all right? Like, how are things? Like, can you drive again? But when it comes to mental illnesses, I feel like it takes a little bit more of a push for many people in our society to treat it like the medical condition that it is. So when you ask this person, how are you managing? How is your depression? It could open up doors to have them explain, have they, you know, maybe started talking to a doctor? Have they started taking any medication? Or if not, then what's holding them back? It's a way of really legitimizing this person's medical condition, which is their depression. And once again, opening up that door to talk about how is treatment going? If this person is receiving treatment. And once again, is there anything I can do to help you? This is just as important as the first time you ask them, because once again, depression just doesn't come and go. It's not a one day thing. It's not a one month thing. It's very, very different for each and every person who struggles with depression. So maybe a month down the line, 6 months down the line, doesn't matter how many times you've checked in with them, they might still be struggling with getting their basic needs met. So once again, you're showing them, hey, I didn't just mean this a month ago or 6 months ago. I mean it now. Is there anything I can do for you today concretely? Third thing we can do to talk to someone or to help someone who might be going through depression is show them you care. I know we can all assume, like, that person knows I care about them. We've gone through so much. We've been friends for 10 years. Or, oh, like, if it's a family member, oh, mom knows I care about her. Like, so-and-so knows I care about them. Once again, when someone is going through depression, it's really, really important to just put it out there. Let them know, hey, I care about you. Verbally let them know. I think this is an act that we can do a lot more in society these days. Really pouring out verbal affirmations for people and reminding them of the good things about them. Not just, this isn't just for people who struggle with depression. It just in general with people in our lives, but especially for those who are struggling with depression, it could really, really mean so much to them when they're reminded of how much they are cared for, how much they're loved by the people in the community around them. Another thing you could let them know is, hey, you're not alone. This is really, really important because when someone is struggling with depression, it's very, very likely that they may feel alone in the world, where they might feel like, oh, no one really understands what I'm going through. A lot of that is a negative stigma that comes with mental health illnesses and diagnoses, unfortunately. But when you let them know, you know, like speak to them, hey, you're not alone. Don't just assume that they would know that. Once again, it will show them that you support them and that they are not alone in this world. And if they need help, they have you or people around them who can help them get through. Another thing you could say is, hey, I don't know exactly what you're going through, but it seems like it's really hard. It looks like it's really hard. This is really important, the way that it's worded, because it validates their own personal experience of going through this really hard thing called depression, letting them know, I don't know exactly what you're going through, but it's validating that they are going through something really rough and it's okay. I can't fully understand, but you are really struggling and I see that, I validate that. And that also means so much to someone who's going through depression. And obviously, since we're talking about things to do and things to say, I wanted to take some time to talk about things that we really shouldn't do when we're talking to someone who may be struggling with depression. Number one, try not to give unsolicited advice. I know when we care about someone, I'm like this too. I really tried to work on this within myself as well. I want to give advice because I want to help them, right? It usually comes from a place of good, wanting to help and support someone who might be struggling. However, when someone is going through depression, when you give them unsolicited advice, it actually might end up harming them more than helping them. For example, did you go to the doctor? That could trigger some responses from this person going through depression because maybe they did and they had a negative experience with some medication or with therapy. Or maybe they don't want to go to the doctor because they're afraid and there's some things that they need to kind of figure out with some self-reflection before they go to a doctor. Or maybe there's some insurance issues and financial issues why they can't go to a doctor. So as you can see, you might mean well when you said, hey, oh, you're not well, you should go to a doctor. However, because you don't know exactly what the other person is going through, saying that could actually end up harming the person. So it's just best at the end of the day to not give unsolicited advice to someone who is struggling with depression. Don't try to make them feel better. I did that a lot too, and even in everyday life now, I try to catch myself when I do that, because once again, I want to make this person I care about feel better. So I could say words that really don't mean anything, like, hey, everything will be okay. Hey, the sun will come out tomorrow. Hey, it'll go away. It's okay. I felt depressed before too. Don't worry. Those things can end up once again harming someone rather than helping them, because even if you mean well, it's a very, very, very delicate time in this person's life when they're going through depression. So don't try to shove these really nice words and phrases that mean well. Don't shove it at them, because at the end of the day, it really won't be that helpful, because it doesn't make the depression go away. So it kind of trivializes this person's pain and this person's experiences. Don't try to figure out the why. I think a lot of the times when we are faced with a problem, we try to figure out the source. Like, what was the trigger? What led to this, right? So when someone tells you, oh, I'm struggling with depression, don't try to use all the mechanisms in your mind to try to figure out, why is this person depressed? Oh, is it because of coronavirus? Oh, that must be it. Oh, is it because they're struggling finding a job? That must be it. Try not to fix their depression, because a lot of the times, like 99% of the times, it doesn't work that way. Depression is a very complex mental illness that has a lot to do with obviously environmental factors, but also in the balance of chemicals inside someone's mind and body. As people who are not medical professionals and people who are not psychiatrists, who don't know what is exactly going on in this person's mind, it's important to try not to fix their problem. And it could also end up trivializing this person's pain. A lot of the times, many people who struggle with depression, not understanding the why can be really, really stressful for them. We as humans, I think we always like to think there's a reason for why things happen. There's a reason why this happened, whether good or bad. But many times, there might not be a reason. You are just feeling these symptoms of depression. You are just feeling these symptoms of anxiety. A lot of the times, it can be environmental, but a lot of the times, there can really just not be a specific trigger. And even if there is one, many people, it takes them years to figure out what that trigger is. So just a few things to take away as I end this video. When trying to talk to someone who has depression, it's extremely important to be very sensitive to them. Don't try to force them to speak to you, force them to do anything. Make sure the ball is always in their court. Like, let them have the power to want to talk to you or want to not talk to you. Don't assume it'll be a back and forth. A lot of the times you might check in, you might ask them, do you want this? Do you need me? Do you need help? And they might say no. And that's that. We have to respect that. But also, make sure to keep checking in. Many times, this act of consistently checking in on someone who has depression can really lead to the difference of life or death. Keep showing them that you're there to support them if they want it, if they need it, in any way possible. And yep, that's it for my video today on how to talk to someone who is struggling with depression. I hope you're able to find this video helpful to you in any way. And also, I got a bit of feedback last week. I was told that my videos are a little bit long, so it's hard to listen through all of it. So moving forward, I'll put in little markers throughout the video, or if I don't know how to do that, I'll put it in the description or comments down below where I talk about certain topics, so you can just go to those numbers. Hopefully that is helpful to you guys. I'm here to help. That's what I'm here for. So thank you for your feedback as usual. I hope you're taking care of yourselves mentally, emotionally, physically. I'm sending you strength, all positive vibes, and support during this really weird year that we're having. I hope you have an absolutely wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!